about that time, about that camp, about that day. Flea market finds. Yeah. You're gonna love the door. They're coming. Oh, what else? Oh, I got in the mail today. This shit works, Marlo. So far. Really? Shut the light off. It's a mini flake buster. All you do is, let me turn some light on over here. Put it on the end of your Wada airbrush. You pull it off, spray your clear, click this on, and it's supposed to shoot up to 0.040 flake. It's a simple construction. Paid, I'll show you in a minute. I guess it sucks air through the top of those holes, swirls it around. Shipping was a ripoff. Yeah, but I seen a video of it. And it'll lay some flake on, and you don't you don't have to mix your flake with the clear, because that's a mess. I don't care what anybody says, because I know it. Oh, where are we at? Good old TC Global. I didn't want to pay that, but I did. This is all I got. Okay, that's fine. It's how big it is. Really, $13.44. That part of it's a ripoff, for sure. Okay, let's move on. Today's been good, bad, and different. All of the above. Yeah. A lot of shit went on today. Anyway, oh, there's my greatest find. Year it is. Got a nice dent in it. I can't tell. It's a drill box. That's old. As far as I can tell, it's not even embossed or anything. And I got this stuff, some Craftsman drill bits, Craftsman screwdriver in it, and oh, I like these the most because I break them. All these little ones, yeah, they were in there. I break them because, yeah, because I force them. And then we got, oh, I got that in that toolbox too. Looks like a eraser wheel. I'm not sure. And I got so many of these little things, it's unreal. I don't know what. This is a Union. I'm gonna try to take the label off and leave it there. Old leather handle. It's got a weird mechanism. Whoa. It's got a weird mechanism. I gotta free it up. But I like those little corner savers. They're not bad. It's not in bad condition. I like it because the top folds all the way back. I like that. I like this little tray that comes out. And this is another Union. It's got the same kind of latch, a little bit different. I never seen a handle like this. I don't know. Somebody had a price on it, what, $25? That ain't even remotely what I paid. It's got some cork stuff in it. I don't know if this is for fishing or what. I don't know. I don't know what this is for. But it's a hassle doing all these little drawers because, yeah, It's a hassle. And then, this is my all-time favorite. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I like this. Little lunch bucket. Back in the 70s. Thermos has been long gone. But it cracks me up that the kid's name's doing it. Goddamn fucking camera. Focus. I had to have that. I'll tell you the little story on this one in a minute. Okay, really? It's rolling through the hood. I don't know about this yet. The starter cover, it's gold leaf, and I just... Come on, turn some light on. That's cleared. I just don't know, man. I don't know. We'll find out. And then, Musty One, you remember this. It's been in primer forever. I painted it flat black. And I got an Eagle Talent coming. Here we go. Okay, the rocker on the driver's side is just caved in. So this is, I'm not saying this is a good rocker. I'm just saying this is a better rocker. That's all I'm saying. Yeah. You won't see none of this. I don't like doing this type of work, but customer dictates it. What are you gonna do? This part of it, you won't see, and you'll see all this, you won't see none of this. Yeah, the supports, I'm sure they're caved. This was nice until it sat outside for 5 years, these parts. This car that I'm gonna do, just one side, quarter and a door, yeah, and put a new rocker in. Well, no, I'm sorry, put a pre-owned, used to be good rocker in it. And then, here's the door. It's gonna be red. And then we're gonna put some, no, we, me, gonna put some Mitsubishi ground effects on it. The bad thing is that, come on. No, that ain't the side. All the clips are mainly broke. So there's, all these are clips and on the Eagle Talent, none of these holes are here, especially these. They're not here, so yeah. And this is a budget build. Yeah. Yeah. So that means none of these, this goes on, I guess, on a Mitsubishi. None of these clips are in the door, so how am I going to do it? I'm not really sure. Yeah. And here we go. Somebody already tried to fix this ground effect. There you go. So we got what? One clip broken off, one clip jerry-rigged on, and we got a crack from here all the way down to the bottom, and somebody put a little Bondo on it. That's nice. And you can tell that they didn't even scuff it. Yeah. Most of it won't show. Like I said, this is a budget build. This is a parking lot. This is a wham bam. Thank you, gotta get on down the road, ma'am. Yeah, this is gonna be, yeah. And the door was in good condition until, like I said, 8 years it sat on the ground. Yeah, apparently this set up, there you go. This is not a good door, this is the other door. This is all I'm gonna say, this is the door that's gonna be used. Yeah, is this gonna be beautiful? No. This is gonna be, yeah. It's gonna be what it is. Y'all know what's right there. Am I put metal in there? No, I'm not gonna. Nope. Time does not allow. No, it doesn't. You can see it's been set for a few minutes. Okay, what else I got to say? No, I'll tell you some stories. Yeah. kill the light. There you go. Commercial break. Some water. Get some popcorn. Maybe you'll be entertained. Maybe you won't. Smoke them if you got them. What do you mean, Milo? Come on. There we go. Let's see if it'll work today. That's first hit. There you go. Looking non-charging motherfucker anyway. Okay. Hey, some bullshit went on today. Let me think. You know, I'm sitting down for this one, yeah. Oh, let me think. The Hot Wheels box. That's the first thing I bought. Do you want $10? I said, no, I'll give you $5. Dude was goofy, but anyway. He said $8. I said $5. He said $7. I said $5. I said, I'll tell you what I'll do. You flip, you call it. You win, you get $7. If I win, I get it for $5. Well, you call it heads, it was tails. I won, got that for $5. That was a good deal. Had to have that. Had to have that. Oh, let me think. I had the Craftsman toolbox in my hand, and I hate when you go to the flea market and they don't have prices on it. It's like it's Craigslist, or you're driving down the road and you see a car that says for sale. Fucking stop. You look at it, it just says phone number. Fuck that. Fuck that. This ain't a guessing game. Do you want to sell the motherfucker or not? Put a price tag on it. Anyway, so you go to the flea market and, you know, look at a toolbox that I'm remotely motherfucking interested in, because if I was interested, I'd buy it, period. But anyway, I asked him how much he wants for it. He said $20. I didn't say one word. Just kept walking. Then he says, What do you offer me for? I said $5. Oh, I can't fucking do that. Still didn't say nothing. And then I showed him the Craftsman toolbox. I was getting ready to say the price, and then I don't know exactly what he said, but he said, I don't give a fuck. I said, hold it, motherfucker. I said, I've held my fucking tongue. Don't run your goddamn jaws to me. Don't. If you would have put a price tag on a motherfucker, I wouldn't be asking you how much it is. Oh, here's another one. Here, Walmart. Walmart fucking sucks. I'm going to tell you just what they did. Yes, I am. Last year, I bought a battery. EverStart, NeverStart. Yep, for my Sporty. Rode it, what, roughly 3 months a year? Okay, because it's only got a 90-day warranty on it or whatever. Okay. So I leave it on a triple charger. Always leave my batteries on a triple charger. So I started this year, you've seen it. Fucker won't even turn over. Barely clicks. So I put more acid in it. Fucking charge it again. It would click. Fuck this. So I went and bought another motherfucking battery. Yep. Charged that goddamn one. Put it in there. Waited a couple days. Took that fucking sales receipt. Put it in the goddamn box and brought it in there. Fucking battery back, because it was bullshit. Battery should last more than a goddamn year. Actually, 3 fucking months. Because of all I ride around here. Anyway, so I go there, and I go to the front, they send me to the back. So I go to the fucking back of Walmart. I hate that fucking hole. I hate some of the employees. So the dude says, I gotta check it. No problem, bro. So he checks it, he says, slow. Okay. I said, it won't even click my bike over. And then he says, put on a charger. I said, what? Put on a charger? I said, I got to charge it my own. Yeah, I got to put on a charger, store policy, whatever. I said, get a manager. I was so nice. Manager comes around named Luke. I said, Luke, do you ride? No. Okay, well, I'm done talking to him, you know. Anyway, he's looking at it. He said, yeah, we got to put it on a charge.
I said, so I gotta wait for a charge? Before he even asked, I said, you know what? No, I ain't wait for no charge. It's inconvenience. I got a slip. He looks like me like deer in fucking headlights. I'm not leaving, fuck this. I'll go up the chain. Well, we'll do it this time. No, you'll fucking do it every goddamn time. Because if you would have sold me a I didn't say this part. If you would have sold me a battery that fucking actually worked, lasted more than a year, I wouldn't be standing here wasting my fucking time. It's not his goddamn money anyway. I hate fucking Never Start Batteries. I hate them. Anyway. I think I've said what I... Oh, it's fucking been 17 minutes. Jeez, okay. Okay. Fuck it. Let's just cut it here. Say goodnight, Irene. Good night. There you go.